Hey, what's up, everybody? This is your boy, Kenny, and this is Empire Season 3, Episode 12, and the name of this episode is Strange Bedfellows. Yeah, this was a really interesting episode because we definitely see, you know, we definitely see Strange Bedfellows throughout this entire episode. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually try to group the scenes together, you know, so I don't take too much time. But if I miss anything, put it down in the comments. I'll be more than happy to talk to you guys about it. So, let's get it popping. Now, the scene that I'm going to talk about right now is the scene involving Jamal's love triangle. The episode opens up where Jamal is pretty much laying up with Phillip, and his notification goes off, and I think it's either Instagram or Facebook live feed, and D Major literally is saying that, you know, I haven't been truthful with myself, I've been hiding who I am for far too long, but I realize that if I don't actually come out, I'm going to lose the most important person in my life. So he's like, Jamal, baby, I'm coming out the closet, I'm letting everybody know that I love you, and I'm on my way to your house right now. And he's laid up with Phillip. And he's like, oh, shit. So they pretty much, in their underwear or whatever. So they get up and they put on their clothes. And man. Okay, that's all I'm going to say. But so they pretty much put their clothes on and everything. And next thing you know, D Major comes off of the elevator. And he's on the live feed like, yeah, Jamal, baby, I'm about to come and I'm about to, I'm about to profess my love to you and shit. He pretty much turns the phone around to see that Jamal is standing there with Phillip, and they both got their shirts off. And he's like, what the hell? And then from that point on, shit just went left. Because, Jamal's like, what the hell are you doing here? What are you doing? He's like, I came out for you. And I'm like, really, nigga? And Phillip just was like, you know what? I'm going to need you to handle this, and I'm going to need you to take care of it, and I'll talk to you later. So Phillip leaves, and then all of a sudden Jamal's like, dude, what kind of game are you on? What the fuck are you doing? Like, what is wrong with you? Like, dude, I told you we were over. He's like, no, I thought that you said that, that if I just came out, that you couldn't be with me if I was in the closet, so I came out the closet so we can be together. And he was like, you know what, you tripping, get the hell up out of my house. And then all of a sudden, next thing you know, this motherfucker loses his attitude. He's like, no! I'm like, oh, okay. So I was like, now we're getting mad. Like, dude, you went out of your way to out yourself, but you never had a conversation with Jamal about doing that. You just decided to out yourself, thinking, okay, this is my way of keeping Jamal under my control, but yet you see that shit didn't work out. So now they also have a scene where they're in the studio. D Major is obviously going through it because he's lost a lot of endorsements. He's lost 3 shows. He's now getting the backlash of coming out being in the hip-hop community. So he's really getting the brush, getting the brush of being now openly gay. So Jamal feels sympathetic to him that, yo, you just came out for me, but we can definitely tell that Jamal is not really feeling D Major in that way anymore. He really is trying to build his thing with Phillip. Next thing you know, Cookie come in there and she shut the shit down. She's like, oh no, you the reason why my son was still, you was pretty much enabling my son with drugs and shit. You need to get the hell out of here because he needs to talk to his mother and you need to go talk to your mother too. Cookie just came in and just completely cleaned house and was like, bye. Get the hell up out of here. And she lets him know, like, look, if you don't stop messing around with him, he gonna ruin your chances with Phillip. And he's like, yeah, just like Lucius is gonna ruin your chances with Angelo if you don't leave Lucius alone. So they kinda go back and forth, like, look, I don't talk about your dirty laundry, don't talk about my dirty laundry. So it's like they kinda got that thing going back and forth with each other. But yeah. It's to the point where, yeah, it's definitely become evident that, yeah, D Major ain't shutting down. So the last thing we've seen with D Major, he tries to get into Empire. he can't get in because his access pass stopped working. And I think that was Cookie. Cookie shut that shit down. I mean, because Cookie is half CEO, so Cookie can, you know, get somebody shut out of getting in the building. So his ass trying to get in. And, well, before that happens, Jamal and Phillip have a conversation, and he's saying that, look, we need to show some compassion to him because he just came out the closet, and coming out in the music industry is really tough. You don't know what that's like. And then Phillip had to remind him, like, yeah, like, coming out in the military. He's like, oh, yeah, yeah, you right. I'm like, yeah. So, yeah, he knows what it's like. So Jamal's like, look, I just think we need to be there for him and show him some compassion. So he's like, okay, I agree with that. I get you. So after D Major's ass couldn't get into the building, but then damn, Phillip comes down there all dressed to the nines and shit, and it's like, look, I understand what you're going through, man. You don't have to, you know, go at it like this. We really want to be here for you. But then D Major takes this as an opportunity to talk his shit. And was like, oh, so you think what you and Jamal got is real? Like, yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, you talking all that jazz, well, I'm going to let you know something. Yeah, no matter what you do, you'll never be able to give it to him the way I do. And next thing you know, Phillip just punched his ass, and I was like, and then Jamal's like, Phillip, and he's like, Phillip looked at him and was like, he had that one coming, and walked away. I was like, he did. Because, really, dude? Because you mad that you don't have Jamal the way that you want Jamal, now you want to talk shit? And be like, well, you ain't gonna be able to give it to him the way I'm giving it to him. I'm like, well, at the end of the day, Jamal don't give a shit. Because if you was giving it to him that damn good, Jamal would still be with your ass. So obviously, you was giving dick while his mind was somewhere else. So, how good is your dick, D Major? So you want to throw your dick around? The dick that don't nobody care about? Really, nigga? Miss me with that bullshit. But as far as I can tell, it ain't over for D Major. And I think D Major is going to become more and more threatening and sinister along the lines, because this fool just came out the closet and Jamal still don't want him. I see a different side coming out of D Major now. But I could be wrong, but that's my hypothesis. So we just have to keep watching to see what's going to happen with that. Next, we see that Cookie, Lucius, and Thirsty are having Mama Walker are having a meeting about Anika, because Anika has been MIA and no one knows what the hell's going on. And then Cookie also wants to know, has Lucius said anything about Anika? Has Lucius said anything to Anika about her? And he's like, well, not to my knowledge, but hey, she may have overheard something maybe, but I've never actually had a conversation about you to her directly. So, but then we get Mama Walker in the meeting, and she pretty much lets it be known, like, look, the White promised me that he was going to get rid of her, and he reneged on his promise. So what I did is I got to Tariq, and I knew that Tariq would get rid of her. And, yeah, because we definitely saw from the last episode that Tariq served her a subpoena and it said that he wanted her and Bella to go in protective custody. And we actually think that's what happened, but she gave Bella to Hakeem. And Hakeem, thinking that they're planning his birthday party, you know, because he's turning 21, he busts into the meeting thinking they planning this party. And like, Cookie's like, boy, we trying to save our lives right now. You know, we'll worry about celebrating later. But then Lucius chimes in on Hakeem. It's like, yeah, you're supposed to be 21. You're supposed to be a man. Then what kind of man lets a woman drop a baby off on him and he doesn't know where she's going or what's going on with her? And he's like, Anika's gone? Anika's not back? So we see that Hakeem is completely lost, that Anika has went MIA. We later on see that she didn't go with Tariq. She actually met up with her parents. Her parents gave her a burner phone, and pretty much she said that, no, if I went to Tariq, you know, Lucius would have me killed. So, you know, my thing is to actually work out a way where I can get in touch with Lucius, you know, so we can work something out so that we all can see Bella again. We actually see later on she ends up doing that. And next thing you know, Lucius actually calls Cookie while Cookie's at the salon trying to get her hair done, but that's a situation that happened there. I'm going to get into that later. And, you know, lets her know that, look, Anika's trying to come home, so I think you might want to come here and let's deal with this. So Anika comes in, Juanita lets her in, she goes upstairs to find Bella, she sees that Bella's gone, next you know, Cookie comes in, then Lucius comes in, and they all like, yo, you need to give us some, you know, a real damn good explanation why we shouldn't off your ass right now. So she's like, look, I got a plan, you know, and she let it be known that, look, me and Bella could have went under protective custody, and Tariq would have had us, and Lucius like, well, why didn't you do it? Because she says, I know something. She's like, because I was putting it all together. Tariq is jealous of you, and he's also jealous the fact that you had your father. You know, you actually had a close connection to your father more than he did. So he definitely has it out for you. But she says that what I'll do is that I'll offer myself to Tariq, you know, because one person that can get to Tariq is me. I can offer myself to Tariq, so therefore when Tariq tries to come for you guys, everything will be thrown out because now he's involved. He's a now strange bedfellow. He's now in bed with us, so therefore anything he tries to say or do will no longer have any weight. So he lets her know, like, you got a week to put this shit together. Oh, but Mama Walker was giving to me this scene because she's like, you know, give me a reason why I shouldn't kill you right now. And then all of a sudden, Mama Walker, let me do it, Dwight. Let me kill her. Let me take her out. And she was just so game to kill Anika. And Lucius had to be like, Mama, calm down. Mama, we trying to handle business right now. Go sit down, Mama. Then her ass comes back with Cookie's gun that she found in Cookie's purse and was like, let me do it right now. Let me offer. Ooh, give me the go-ahead. And she was just so amped. And then, like, Lucia's like, give me the gun, Mama. Give me the gun. Give me the gun, Mama. So he lets Nika know, like, look, you got 1 week, or I'm gonna turn my mama on too. I was like, yes, like, as Mama Walker was ready to put one in Anika, honey. She was trying to make Anika take that long dirt nap. And then later on, she meets up with Tariq, and she literally gets in with Tariq, and Tariq definitely got a soft spot for pussy, because he was just like, yeah, I got you, and you know, when things go down, I'm going to protect you. I have you under my protective custody. And she pretty much acts like she hasn't been talking to Lucius and that she's on the run from Lucius, not knowing that she's actually in cahoots with Lucius. And then all of a sudden she hugs him and she smiles, so she's like, got his ass. Also, pretty much we had a little bit with Cookie and Angelo. Angelo pretty much is upset that she met with Lucius. And he's saying that, look, I thought we discussed that when it comes down to Lucius, you'll let me kind of, like, take the lead on things and won't be so much meeting up with Lucius so much behind my back or whatever. And she's like, yeah, I know. And she's saying that, look, I know y'all got a business together. I know y'all have children together. But, you know, I'm trying to build something for us, too. You know, I'm about to be mayor. You know, and I really want to build a strong foundation between the both of us. So it's like, yeah, Angelo's really trying to become that power couple, you know, with him and Cookie. And next thing you know, he actually finds Cookie's gun. And he's like, are you crazy? What are you doing with this? And she pretty much says it was a gift. And he was like, look, you know, I'm about to be mayor. You know that having a handgun in New York is a felony. You know, so what the hell is going on with this? And she's like, okay, I'll get rid of it. And then he begins to ask her, have you ever used the gun? She laughs and says no, but we get a flashback when she's sitting in the hotel room that her and Lucius are sharing after she was kicked out from her father's house, one of Lucius' boys come over, and she's like, Lucius ain't here. And he begins to try to push up on her, thinking he's going to get some of Cookie's stuff. And Cookie pulls out a gun, and she shoots old boy in the damn knee. Like, no, nigga. I told you Lucius' ass ain't here. But his ass wouldn't leave. Because he was just thinking he was going to smash with Cookie, and Cookie wasn't having that shit. But she told Angelo no. But, yeah, we know that, yeah, Cookie will fuck somebody up. And then we actually see that they actually go to, like, some event with him on the night of Hakeem's birthday party. And we see that her and Angelo are becoming more and more close. The question is, will it last, or will she give in to the feelings that she may still have for Lucius? Next, what I'm going to discuss is Juliana's ass. Now, we actually have a scene where Andre is literally trying to smash Juliana. He's definitely trying to make this business deal. You know, Juliana, we actually have a scene where Nessa's singing, and I think it's at Leviticus or whatever. I don't know. It's pretty much at some club, and, you know, Nessa's rehearsing, and he meets up with Juliana, and Juliana's like, so is that your girl? And Andre's like, yeah, that's my girl. And he said, I would like for her to open up, you know, at one of your spots in Vegas. And she's like, well, the thing is, I don't have a cabaret license and all of that. He's like, we'll work that out. We'll get that taken care of. But he's like, yeah, you know, I think, you know, she's definitely, you know, one of Empire's main artists now. So why not have her kind of like, you know, start the whole business thing, you know, going with her performing and opening up at one of your clubs. And she's like, okay, you know, and they pretty much kind of like negotiating the deal of them in Vegas. But we can definitely tell there's a lot of flirting going on between the both of them. And later on, we see that she starts throwing her weight around because Cookie goes to her hairstylist to get her hair done. Damn, Juliana then took her spot, paid two stacks, and had two bodyguards. So it's like she completely is now trying to come for Cookie and decided to take Cookie's spot. So Cookie was really about to wreck her ass before she got that call from Lucius discussing Anika, and then Cookie left. And the hairstylist was like, I'm sorry about that. She's like, no, it's okay. You know, sometimes you just have to take out the trash. I'm like, Juliana, you fucking with my Cookie. So at the end of the day, bitch, your days are numbered. So yeah, you think you gonna come for Cookie and your shit ain't gonna come back on you? Bitch, you got another thing coming. But we later on see that Juliana and Andre have another meeting, because she actually told him the last time that, you know, we should have a meeting later on personally between me and you. So, and we literally see that Andre is ready to give her the dick. Like, he is. This fool is literally, like, putting his dick on the table saying, like, yo, let's get to know each other better. So do you want to stay here, or do you want to go somewhere more private? You know, he is literally throwing himself at her. And she's like, well, the thing is, bro, you got a girl. And I don't ever, you know, mess with another girl's man unless I have permission. So you can kind of calm all that down. But she says that, look, I'll overlook the contracts. And if anything, if I like what I see, we'll do business. But, you know, because Andre was trying to steal that deal right then and there. But he was trying to steal that deal, you know, with something else. And she wasn't having it, because even though she flirts back with him, she's kind of like having the power over it. Like, nah, I'm going to make you crawl a little bit more to get this. You ain't going to get it when you want it. So she's playing the game. Next, we actually see she meets up with these cats. The main dude's name is Gino, who had did previous business with her husband, Raphael, who's now dead. So she pretty much says that, oh yeah, Raphael was scamming you all these years. She gives him all this money, of all the money that Raphael had robbed him of, and she says that now me and you can do business. And he was like, well, first of all, I've only did business with Raphael, and all of a sudden now you doing all this shit. It's like, what makes you think I can trust you? Why shouldn't I off you right now? And he said that, and she said, because I have Lucius Lyon, and I know you've been trying to get at Lucius, but you only can get through Lucius, the only way you're going to get through Lucius is through me. So I'm like, hostile takeover. So we definitely can see that Juliana does not have good intentions, you know, and I think in time we're going to find out, you know, how messy and sinister Juliana can really be. So we're already starting to see early on that, yeah, Juliana definitely has a plan. And we're going to actually see how she enacts that plan. Next I'm going to talk about is Hakeem's birthday party. Hakeem is so lit, is so hot. You know, he is in his mind is thinking that no one's coming to his birthday party because Hakeem has decided to live stream his whole, you know, birthday extravaganza, because what he's going to be doing, he's going to be hopping from club to club, getting crowds of people, and I think the final destination is going to be a Leviticus. And right now, Keanu's on tour, but, you know, so he's kind of feeling a little salty about that his girl ain't there, but, you know, she out there making that money. And Portia is one of the people who's presiding over his, you know, events and stuff, so she's pretty much, you know, setting everything up. And we actually saw earlier that him and Andre got into it because Andre's like, what the hell are you doing? Why are you live streaming all of your, you know, your whole birthday celebration? And he's like, man, I'm doing what I gotta do and all this other shit. So they kind of go back and forth. And then Lucius is like, nah, it's his day. Let him live stream if you want to live stream. But yeah, I'm not going to be able to make it though because I got a prior engagement. And he's like, man, it seemed to me that everybody got something to do on my birthday, man. And then when he walked away, they all started laughing. So they kind of messing with him, making him think they forgot his birthday, but they didn't. He's like, yeah, we got some stuff in the bag for him. We're going to work this out with him. We're just going to let him grovel a little bit. So next thing you know, we see that Hakeem is at this one club. I think it's called the Spectacular or something like that. I could be wrong. But he's at this club. You know, they turning up and having a good time. But the thing is, you know how some clubs are. Like, they'll ask for certain celebrities to come to their club, and they'll pretty much invest in this celebrity, you know, because celebrities actually bring in business to the club. So that was, I think, the initial deal that they had, that, you know, they would have a certain amount of bottles, a certain amount of everything, and they'll be turning up and having a good time, which will also highlight the club as well. Next, and then also is bringing in more and more people. So all of a sudden they go to you know, get the money from, you know, from the club owner. You know, the club owner got all his goons with him and shit. So we can already see that this motherfucker is already has a plan to shake down Hakeem. And he's like, nah, you know, instead of him giving him money, he gives Hakeem a bill, saying that you guys been popping all these bottles and all of that, you know, shoot, you know, that shit costs, so, you know, you got a bill. He's like, nah, that one what we discussed, you know. He's like, I'm Hakeem Lyon. He's like, yeah, exactly, you Hakeem. You not Cookie, you not Lucius, you not Jamal. You know, I was thinking he was going to bring the whole family, but since the whole family in here is just you, I mean, hey. You know, I'll tell you what, if you go up there and spit a few bars for me, then yeah, maybe even worse than now. He's like, nah, man, I don't rap for free. You got me real fucked up. Then all of a sudden, these goons who was with Hakeem pretty much like, you need to pay the man. And then all of a sudden, dude decides to back down and shit, and was like, okay, and he gives Hakeem the money. Then Hakeem's like, oh yeah, let me get that watch too. So they run the dude's watch, and then he kind of like throw money at his ass, like, get the fuck out of here, bitch. So now, then all of a sudden, Hakeem looks at the two dudes like, yo, I don't know who y'all are, I don't know where y'all came from, but y'all rolling with us. And I'm like, see, I already can tell right now this is going to be a fucking problem. Then all of a sudden, we actually see that Tiana shows up, and she shows up with some of her girlfriends, and one of the goons likes one of the girls. Her name is Kennedy. So they pretty much go on, whatever, and then they end up at Empire. Tiana ends up doing a performance along with Jamal. They bring Hakeem on stage, and they performing and having a great time. The next thing you know, the goon and the girl Kennedy are getting into it because the dude is being real forceful and wants to get with her, but she's not really feeling him like that. And she's like, and he's like, yo, man, won't you do a little something for me, yo? Why are you trying to sweat a brother? Give a brother some attention. And she's just not trying to give him no attention. She's like, yo, you need to back up off me. And then he starts grabbing on her and shit. And she's like, yo, get off my arm. You're hurting me. And, you know, all of a sudden we see Hakeem from the stage. She's like, yo, calm down. Next thing you know, this big nappy-headed nigga decides to punch her. And he literally punched her as if she was a dude. Because she wouldn't give him no play. And next thing you know, it just led to this big-ass fight. There was glass being broken, you know, bodies being thrown, everybody's running out, and Hakeem's birthday party was ruined just like that. But then Hakeem is in his fucking feelings, because he's like, my B-Day was just ruined. This is the worst birthday ever. He's pretty much talking to Tiana, and he's like, my birthday's ruined. And she's like, really, dude? You talking about your birthday when yet one of my good friends just got hit and she's on her way to the hospital? You ain't even once asked about how she's doing. She's like, I'm going to the hospital. And he's like, but my birthday was ruined. And she's like, typical Hakeem, always thinking about you. And then next thing you know, we see him and Andre get into it. Andre is pissed. But then again, it makes me question, did Andre have something to do with this shit? You know, did he set those goons up there? Or did somebody else do that shit? Like, where the hell these damn goons come from? And then, on top of it, you know, Hakeem had paid them money. So Andre was mad as shit. He was like, first of all, you paid these niggas money, so therefore you made them fucking employees of Empire, and you did all this shit live, and it became a big-ass fucking mess. We talking about trying to prevent liabilities for you, because you said, I had bodyguards there with you, but you turned them down. He's like, yeah, I turned them down because I thought you was trying to set me up. And he was like, bruh, really? So now you done created a big-ass mess. Now, you know, you have become a liability to the company because now we have these people on payroll, and now you done created this big-ass mess. He's like, you know what? You're 21, right? He's like, you a man, right? He's like, yeah, I've been a man. He's like, okay. Well, being a man comes with responsibilities. So as of now, you are officially shut down. I'm shutting down your live stream permanently. And I'm like, Hakeem, you fucking up, bruh. So then he has a conversation with Jamal, and Jamal pretty much in the same line says that, look, now is the time for you to grow up. Now's the time for you to realize that, yeah, you can't do this shit no more. So we next see that he goes to Lucius's house to get Bella, and he's like, he's like, look, I have a little bit of time for my birthday. I want to spend the rest of my birthday with my daughter. And that touched Lucius so much that he begins to talk about how Hakeem was conceived and how he delivered Hakeem, that he was actually delivered at home because they weren't able to get to the hospital in time. But he was saying that, you know, now I see that my son has become a man, and now that you will protect your daughter with all of your ability. So he pretty much gives Bella to him, and he says, happy birthday, son. And that's how it ended. So yeah, it was a really interesting episode, and a lot went down. But if I miss anything, put it down in the comments. But yeah, I can definitely see there's a lot of shit that's going to be coming in, you know, that's going to be coming in the future. But yeah, subscribe to my channel. Click that bell so you can get notifications every time I do a video. Like this video, share this video, and comment on this video. And I will be back next week for the next episode of Empire. So until then, everybody, take care.